If you're someone who has always wanted to try your hand at composting, but weren't sure if you could do it while living in an apartment, I think we've got something for you. For those of us who live in apartments with limited outdoor spaces or in regions with extreme winters, taking up an initiative like composting food scraps might seem tricky. But having done this for around 2 years now, we can assure you that you can definitely compost at home as long as you have a tiny little corner and maybe a couple of hours to build yourself a compact composter. This design is inspired by the composters we found online at Daily Dump, which is actually a company based out of India. I urge you to definitely check out the website to learn just about the big picture and why we all need to compost our organic waste instead of just sending it to landfills, and easy solutions to do that. If we had an option to buy these composters and have it delivered to where we live, we surely would have just purchased it and not taken the pain to build one. So if you live in India, definitely do check out their products. Moving on. To build a stack of 3 compost bins, we use 3 of 14-inch terracotta pots with drainage holes and 3 of the 14-inch saucers as well, which would be used as lids. These are available in most garden centers or Walmart and each costs roughly around $10. We found that these pots are the right size for easy handling, but if you would prefer something still smaller, you can just go down a size in the pots and the lids. The reason we need 3 of these bins is because it takes somewhere between 1.5 to 2 months for organic matter to fully decompose and to be ready to be used. So usually for an average 2 to 4 member household, having 3 of these pots would make sure we can fill one pot after another and still have place to dump our food scraps. We could certainly use the terracotta pots as it is and just stack them up and use them for composting, or we could add a few more extra holes in the surface of the pots for a little more ventilation. For doing that, we need a power drill and a masonry drill bit. We used a 3x16 inch thickness one. So this entire project should cost you around $70 if you go with the terracotta pots. Before drilling the holes, we definitely want to soak the pots in water overnight so it has enough moisture and doesn't crack. We placed ours in a bucket of water overnight. If you do not have a bucket, you could just fill up your bathtub and place them in as well. After at least 10 hours of soaking, we drilled around 8 to 10 holes on the surface of each pot. If you've never drilled holes in terracotta pots before, it certainly can instill patience in you. You want to go about it with every 10 seconds or so of drilling and then wiping down the surface and the drill bit with some water. So it accelerates the process and makes the clay more smoother and easier to drill. You also want to make sure that the pot is against a wall or some support so you can apply the needed pressure. Drilling one hole can take up to 2 or 3 minutes. You can use this with just a rustic look of terracotta, but if you're like me and prefer a splash of color, you could paint the pots as well. In the summer months, we usually keep ours in the balcony, and when it gets really cold, between November and March, we bring it in and leave it at the corner of our dining area. If you have any concerns or thoughts that it might be odd to have a compost bin near your dining area, trust me, if done right, composting has absolutely no odors or attracts no insects at all. Even when you mix the compost piles, you should only get an earthy smell, maybe something similar to the fresh and the beautiful smell when we get when it rains and the soil is moist. It should be something like that. We will talk about the process of composting and share our learning in a more detailed video later, but the very basic need is to start separating your dry and wet waste. We usually add our vegetable scraps and fruit peels to a separate container over the week. Just being more mindful of the type of waste we generate at home is actually a very good starting point to be more sustainable. We will see you guys in another video soon. Until then, happy gardening.